So, dear students, let's start with the topic of calorimetry. When we talk about calorimetry, we can define it as it is the process of measurement of heat exchanges between different substances. So, calorimetry is basically the measurement and analysis of heat exchanges between substances. We can state if there is a substance and say we supply heat to it, say an amount delta Q of heat is supplied to the substance. There are two phenomena which can take place. The one is rise in temperature. If heat is supplied, the temperature of substance may increase, say by delta T. Or it may also be possible that on supplying heat, its temperature won't increase, its phase will change. So, another phenomena is change of phase. For phase change, we can define it in many ways, like say if there is a solid heat is supplied, the phenomena of melting can take place. If there is a liquid, it may vaporize, the phenomena of vaporization can take place. Or it may also be possible that a solid directly sublimate, the phenomena of sublimation can take place, in which a solid directly vaporize. Now, step by step, we'll discuss both of these phenomena in detail with various example. Like when we talk about rise in temperature, so we can say, if temperature increases by delta T on supplying a heat dq, I think in your early classes you already studied that the amount of heat required to raise the temperature of a substance by a given amount, this heat is directly proportional to the rise in temperature. Say if this is our first equation, and we can also state this heat supplied is directly proportional to the mass of the substance. And if we combine the two, we can state delta Q is equals to, we can write it ms delta T, where S is a proportionality constant, which we call a specific heat of substance. And it is a constant for a given substance for a given temperature range. For majority of cases, we consider for a given physical substance, the value of a specific heat remains constant within our scope of a study. Actually, the specific heat also depends on temperature, but that is beyond the limitation of our lecture. So, we are not going to discuss about the variation of a specific heat with temperature. However, some examples we are going to analyze how to mathematically calculate the amount of heat if the specific heat changes with temperature. Let's discuss about a specific heat of a substance. About a specific heat, you already studied in your early classes, as by definition we can state it is the amount of heat required to raise the temperature of unit mass of substance by 1 degree centigrade, if we are using temperature units to be in degree centigrade. As we have just now studied that the amount of heat required, we can write as ms delta T. Here if we use, if mass is 1 kilogram for a substance and the rise in temperature is 1 degree centigrade, this implies we can see the value of heat supplied is equals to S, which is the specific heat. And about the specific heat, we can write down its unit. Specific heat can be measured in units of joule per kilogram degree centigrade, or we can use joule per kilogram Kelvin. in CGS units, or we can also convert this joule into calories. It can be written as calorie per gram degree centigrade. Or various systems, in various systems we can define different specific heats of different units of a specific heat. Now for a substance, some important point we can note down, like for a substance, if S is low, there are so many different substances which are having very low specific heat, and in case of low specific heat, this implies that small delta Q will result large rise in temperature. Generally, all metals are having very low specific heat, in which a very small amount of heat will also result a large increase in temperature. Similarly, if in some cases, if we can write if S is high, in such cases we can state even large delta Q, that is, even if we supply large amount of heat, it will result small increase in temperature. There are many substances like non-metal, even if we talk about wood, then also we can state large amount of heat also, it will result a small increase in temperature. So we can state for generally metals, we can write the specific heat is low, and for generally in case of non-metals, the specific heat is high. Similar to specific heat of a substance, we define one more parameter that is termed as heat capacity or thermal capacity of a body. We can define it as it is the amount of heat required to raise the temperature of a given body by 1 degree centigrade, or whichever unit we use. It is denoted by C and it can be defined as ms. S is the amount of heat required to raise the temperature of unit mass by 1 degree. So, if we multiply it by the mass of body, it will become the amount of heat required to raise the temperature of the given body by 1 degree centigrade, and its units can be simply written as joule per degree centigrade, or we can write joule per Kelvin, or we can write calorie per degree centigrade, etc., that we can use. But you just keep in mind that thermal capacity of a body, this can be given as mass multiplied with the specific heat of the substance.